So let's have a look at what the heart is and what the heart does. Now, before you do any exercise, just pop that on your finger.
Got it.
So this is a little gadget that's going to tell us Maddie's heart rate. So how fast her heart is beating, how many times it beats every minute. Now, right now you're kind of reasonably relaxed, although we're live to 6,500 people.
I know, I say it might be a little bit stressed.
It might be a little bit higher than normal. But if we were to listen to her heart rate, this is what it would sound like.
Oh, so it's sort of like a gentle lub-dub, lub-dub.
Yeah, exactly. So, do we have a number?
We do. We do. But it's already really high.
It's already really high.
Partly because we're doing a live show on the internet.
So that's how many times your heart is beating every minute. Our resting will be between 60 and 80. What I'm also going to do, actually, is I want to look at your temperature.
Ah, okay. So this is, of course, one of my favourite things. Greg is using a thermal imaging camera. And a thermal imaging camera, it shows us how hot and cold things are using colour. So warm, hot things will often look yellow. That's our ironing board.
That's our ironing board. It is a spare room, everybody.
Hot things will often look yellow, red, or even white. So if you can see there, look where I'm really, really warm. And then cooler things will look blue and purple.
So your face is about 35 degrees.
Okay, all right.
Right now, degrees C. So we're going to come back and have a look at that again in a minute.
Right.
All right, so now I need to start doing some exercise. Up you jump.
I'm feeling it. Okay, all right then.
Okay, so you get to do some work. Now, I want you lot to predict work. Now, I want you lot to predict and write in the live chat what you think is going to happen to Maddie's heart rate and to Maddie's temperature, because that's what we want to focus on. So let's have a look first at her heart. If I asked you to draw a picture of a heart, this is probably what you would draw. Now, that's cool, but actually a heart looks more like this. So that is what a heart looks like. And if you're wondering what size a heart is, if you make a fist with your hand, that is about the size of your heart. So everyone do that. And then what I want you to do is I want you to squeeze and release, squeeze and release, squeeze and release. And that is exactly what your heart is doing. It's squeezing and releasing to pump blood around your body. And let's find out what Maddie's heart rate is right now.
Okay, it's up to 105.
Wow, so it's jumped from her normal resting of 60 to 80 to 105. Good, okay, so she's doing some work. So if we were to listen to her heart rate, it would sound more like this now. Have a listen. Wait, you, he's working out.
Sorry.
Give you some more music to work out to. So why is your heart pumping fast? So on Monday, we talked about digestion. And we talked about how digestion breaks the food that you eat down into fuel, into simple sugars. And then that goes into the blood. Well, it's your heart's job to pump that blood around your body so that that fuel gets to your muscles. So right now, Maddie is doing exercise. She needs more fuel to get to her muscles. So her heart is beating faster to get more of that fuel, more of that sugar to her muscles to make energy. Okay, you can stop. You can stop.
Okay.
Let's stop you. What is your heart rate?
Well, right now, I'm just going to try and wait for this.
Okay.
I'm really out of breath.
Let's have a look at your temperature while we're there.
So okay,
all right
then.
Let's go to the camera. And let me put that on your face. Whoa, you are absolutely glowing.
Okay, does it say that I'm warmer?
Okay, so your face has gone up by about 1 degree.
Okay.
But your chest and your neck, whoa, that's much warmer. That's now about 36, 37 degrees C. And the reason that you've got so much warmer is because your body, your muscles are working hard. They're using that fuel to make energy. Do we have a number?
We do. We have a number. It has settled on...
Wow.
155.
155 beats per minute.
Is that
so
accurate?
Yeah,
that feels
so
like a lot.
You have been working hard, Mads. Good job.
I'm definitely feeling out of breath.
Out of breath, because not only is your heart working hard, but also your lungs are working hard. Do you think you can use those lungs to tell us about lungs?
Yeah, definitely. Okay. Actually, if everybody puts their hands on their chest right now, that's it, join me. Gently, now take a big breath in and a big breath out. So you should be able to feel your chest moving up and down. Yeah. And that is your lungs. They are filling with air and then they are releasing air. That's what you can feel.
Yeah.
Now, each of us, we have two lungs. They're full of tubes, a little bit like branches on the end of the tree.
Mm.
But actually, I think they look a bit more like broccoli, if you can imagine. So there's a long pipe here, which we call the trachea. And the air we breathe, it goes down the trachea and then eventually it will go to the little tubes and then the bunches that we see on the end.
So that air that you talk about us breathing in, there's something really important in that air that's called oxygen. And we've talked about your muscles needing fuel to create energy.
Yeah.
But they don't need just fuel. They also need oxygen.
Ah,
so
okay.
Your lungs are amazing. Your lungs get the oxygen into your blood and your heart pumps the oxygen and the fuel to your muscles.
Okay, so our bodies need two things to make energy. They need fuel and they need oxygen.
Yes.
You can all get your bodies moving at home too. But don't worry if you don't have one of these. We call it a pulse oximeter.
No.
You can always just gently take your fingers and then just hold them to your wrist and you might be able to feel your pulse, feel that lub dub of your blood pumping through. But Oliver and Luke, they got in touch because their mummy showed them a trick using some blue tack and a paper straw. And this trick let them see a pulse in action.
This is super cool.
Hello, Maddie. Look at mummy's hand. It's her pulse. Her pulse is her heartbeat.
Wow! It's sort of like
a clever little setup.
It's like a little seesaw sort of going bing, 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 and that is the blood pumping through. So maybe that's something that you could try at home.